Today we're going to finish the design challenge for the crane electromagnetic interference problem. Last time we figured out how to measure the current at the midpoint of the crane. We also figured out that grounding the crane increases the amplitude of the crane at the midpoint of the crane. So now we need to come up with another idea for reducing the amount of current on the crane. We started to consider an equivalent circuit for the input impedance of an antenna. We discussed that at resonance, which is when an antenna radiates or receives the most power. So at resonance, R rad is largest, and the reactance X in is the smallest, so that goes to zero. So perhaps one idea is to tweak this imaginary part of the impedance of the crane, X in. If we can shift the crane further away from resonance, then the crane should be a less efficient antenna and the current along the crane should decrease. How would you suggest we change the reactance of the antenna, X in? Well, the impedance of an inductor is purely imaginary. ZL is J omega L. And the impedance of a capacitor is also purely imaginary, 1 over J omega C. So what if we try adding a capacitor or an inductor at the base of the crane? Maybe we could use that to tweak this X in value of the crane. In this case, our model might look like this, with a lumped element at the base of the crane. Maybe we can first try adding a capacitor at the base of the crane. And if that doesn't seem to help, we can instead try adding an inductor. Since we are using FDTD to solve Maxwell's equations, we can model a capacitor or an inductor in an FDTD model if we can figure out how to account for the capacitor or the inductor in Maxwell's equations. For convenience, here are Maxwell's equations, in both the pointwise and the integral form. You can consider either form. What do you think is the best way to account for a capacitor or an inductor in Maxwell's equations?